Hey everyone, I'm Cameron with SpeedCubeShop.com, here with probably our most important video I'll make on this channel, which is my 5 top tips to get a sponsorship with SpeedCubeShop.com. We get sponsorship inquiries every day, all day long, from people all over the world, and I really want to help you guys understand what goes into our decision-making process and some things that you can do to improve your chances of being accepted. So the first thing just off the bat is that you don't always get accepted because you're not fitting the requirements. It might just be that we're not currently accepting at that time and we'll reach back out to you in the future whenever we are. So if you don't always get accepted, don't feel bad. Read what our feedback is, because we will always give you feedback as to why you weren't accepted. And then you can either look to improve on what we suggested, or you can wait until we are looking to add to our team. Tip number 2 is originality. This is a really tricky one that I cannot just give you the secret recipe for, because originality is something that is original to you. So I don't know what's gonna make your video special if you're watching this, but I can tell you that slapping some techno music onto a cube review is not very original. And if you are relying on products to make your videos, and we get people all the time that say, oh, well, I can't make content unless you send me free stuff. And look, some of the top YouTubers that we have worked with have always started just either on their own or making informative or educational content, or just engaging content in general. So find what works for you and work on improving that. Tip number 3, writing a good application. People misinterpret this as giving us paragraphs and paragraphs of text saying how great SpeedCube Shop is and how we're the best cubing store in the world, which isn't a lie, but at the same time, kind of kissing up to us isn't gonna be the way to get a sponsorship. You wanna tell us about yourself and what you bring to the table. Why should we sponsor you over one of the other hundreds of applications we received that week? What makes you special, and what are you gonna do for our brand? Be sure to hit on what you're gonna do, what you offer, your background, and give examples of your work. I can't emphasize that enough. If you have social medias, link them. If you have a YouTube channel, link it. If you're a SpeedCuber, link your WCA profile. Be sure to give us all the information that we need when making a decision for your application. Tip number 4, going off of tip number 3, is gonna be providing value. So many people seem to think that sponsorships are just a you get free stuff and that's where it ends. A sponsorship needs to be going both ways and be mutually beneficial. So that means that we will give you merchandise, publicity, include you in our promotions, and include you in whatever else we're gonna be doing, whether it's events, you know, all that kind of stuff. And what are you gonna do for us in return? Typically, that's gonna be advertising and promotion through social media, content, or wearing our merchandise at competitions, using our products, and just kind of spreading the word about our products and services. So make sure that you are willing to provide good value. And if you're just looking to get free stuff through your sponsorship, then it probably is not gonna be a very good long-term situation for both you and for your sponsor. Tip number 5, believe in the brand. I would highly advise against applying for a sponsorship for SpeedCube Shop or really any other company if you don't actually like the products or the services, or just believe in what the brand stands for. So look at the brand as a whole. Do you kind of align with it? Do you like how we do things? Do you like our vibe? Do you like our morals? Do you like look at what we've done in the last few years and see, you know, like how we've grown, or look at what we've actually done, as in don't just like listen to what we say, look at what we've done. I can't tell you how disingenuous it comes off when someone is just completely shilling a product and doesn't actually believe in it or use it themselves. To give you an idea, it would be like someone who is sponsored by Nike going and using Adidas on their free time. It's not a good look and makes you kind of lose credibility. And I'm gonna give you guys a bonus tip, tip number 6, which is do not beg, and where to contact us for a sponsorship. We went and spent the time to make a whole sponsorship section on our FAQ, which I'll have a link to in the description box down below. Make sure you read it. Make sure you follow and submit an application only if you qualify. We can't tell you how frustrating it is going through all these applications for people who clearly do not meet the requirements, because it takes away time and resources from us to review applications for people who actually do qualify. And again, just is a really bad experience and just shows us that you're not capable of following directions and reading what we have laid out. So it doesn't really make you a great candidate for sponsorship. When it comes to begging, begging is not a way to get what you want, guys. Do not beg. And if you're hitting us up on Instagram or Facebook DMs or YouTube comments begging for a sponsorship every day, all day long, and then cussing us out if we don't give one to you, again, it's not gonna make us wanna sponsor you. So go through our application process, read all the information there, and submit an application when the time is right and when you meet all of the qualifications. I really hope this was informative for you guys and will help you on your quest to get a sponsorship if you are looking to get one. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment in the comment section down below. Again, I'll have links to our sponsorship FAQ section and all that good stuff that you guys need to get on your way to being a part of Team SES. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.